This year in 2022, we'll be getting the brand new MacBook Air, and it's going to be coming with a brand new chipset, the M2, and those specs have been revealed. We have all the details on this and also the latest on the new MacBook Air release date and price, and of course a summary on the design and specs as well. Hi, it's Matt here. So we're in 2022 and new Macs are coming. But what Macs will be getting the M2 chipset inside, and what will they be capable of? Well, it's been over a year since we had an update to the MacBook Air. The biggest change we saw in that last model was the new Apple Silicon M1 chipset put inside, and also the cooling fan being removed from the model. But with leaks and rumours dropping in for the new MacBook Air, I have decided for all the new MacBook videos like this one going forwards, I'm going to give you the latest details on specific models, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the MacBook starting prices and features that we have learnt in previous leaks. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next MacBook Air. Also, put in the comments below of what features you'd like to see in the next MacBook Air, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. Let's start then with the news of the MacBook Air M2 specs. So the report is coming from Mark Gurman, who is a very well known leaker with a reasonable reputation of getting leaks correct apart from maybe release dates, but for specs wise, he's normally quite reliable. Anyway, Gurman has revealed that the new MacBook Air that will be coming out in 2022 will be one of the first devices to get the new M2 chipset, what is the successor to the M1. This is not an upgrade to the M1 Pro or Max chipset. They are now following their own individual path and will get upgrades most likely in 2023. Gurman has claimed that the M2 will have the same CPU layout as the M1, what has 8 cores, so this is 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, and this will be marginally faster than the M1. We'll likely see the difference between like what we get with the iPhone A14 chipset to the A15 chipset, where we got about a 15% increase in just CPU speed. However, the big part to take away is to do with the GPU power. Right now with the M1, we have an 8 or 7 core GPU in the MacBook Air, but according to Gurman, it is likely that the new GPU will come with a 10 or a binned 9 core GPU. With that 10 core GPU option, this already provides an increase of cores by 25%. And also, knowing Apple, they will have improved the GPU core's performance as well across all of them. So expect in total with the additional cores included for around about a 35 to a 40% increase in GPU power, what is a big jump on the M1 GPU performance. So like a few of my other videos, just a quick note here. With any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumor is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like and want to know what the latest leaks and rumors are, no matter what they tell us. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the release date next, and then a summary of everything we know with the prices included as well. So just quickly guys, recently this channel got over 300,000 subscribers, what is absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I've decided to do a giveaway of this. It is an iPhone 13 Pro Max and it is in white silver and it's a 256GB model option. So recently I've given away a Sierra Blue one when we got over 300,000 subscribers, and I'm going to be giving away this iPhone 13 Pro Max when we get over 350,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is just write down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in 2022. Write it down in the comments below, and also at the same time as well, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because I'll be revealing who the winner is when we get over 350,000 subscribers via a video, and you won't want to miss that notification for that video. Now, quickly, I just want to mention as well, sadly, there are a lot of scammers and spammers out there who use my face, for example, and also tell you to WhatsApp them. This is not me, and I'm afraid they are not giving away any giveaways out there. I'm the only one who's doing the giveaway, and you can make sure it's me by seeing that there is a tick next to my actual name. And also, like I said, that any comments or anything will have that tick, but the actual giveaway itself will be on that actual video when we get over 350,000 subscribers, not before. Well, with that out of the way, let's return back to the video. So, release day. I'm going to make a more dedicated video on the leaks we have heard about it. However, in short, originally we thought until WWDC this year, we could be getting the M2 MacBook Air in 2021, in October or November time. But with these leaks and rumours from Mark Gurman, Ming-Chi Kuo, you can see here with the mini LED, you can see everything is more pointing towards a 2022 release instead. A few other leakers have pointed at early 2022 as well. And we've also got to remember, we've just had the new MacBook Pros, the 14-inch and the 16-inch release with that M1 Pro and M1 Max inside it. And it's likely that Apple will not be launching any more new MacBooks in 2021. So I believe, based on these facts, it is likely that the early 2022 date is on the cards for a release with the new MacBook Air. So going forward, I'm going to be saying 2022 as the release date. But when in 2022, you might ask? Well, as some of the leaks have said in this video, it's going to be early 2022. If Apple's track records of events and announcements is anything to base time on, based on these leaks, I do believe we'll get a 2022 release. But if that release will be in March, April time or the end of the year, I'm not too sure at this time. But I'm sure more leaks and rumours will come out between now and then. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2022 MacBook Air is going to give us and also the prices. So what we've heard for the MacBook Air M2 or the new model that's coming out in 2022, it will be a 13.3 XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. Now it's likely this 13.3 inch display is going to be retained and not upgraded to a 14 inch just yet. The main reason is, even with the new MacBook Pro 14 inch coming out, it is likely Apple are going to still continue to sell the MacBook Pro M1, what has a 13.3 inch display as well, so I'm sure the MacBook Air will also be retaining its same size screen. But the resolution of that screen will be the same of what we get on the MacBook Air right now, what will be a 2560 by 1600, and it will also be a ProMotion display for the first time, what will be a 120Hz refresh rate built into that display, so very similar to the 12.9 inch iPad Pro that we have right now. For storage, it is likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, so 256GB, 512, 1TB and 2TB storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8GB or 16GB of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colours as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumours. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colours ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange and purple, what are the exact same colours that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a centre stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. battery life is going to be the same what we're getting right now, so up to 18 hours if you use it well. And then prices wise, it looks likely that it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, with 256GB starting at $999, 512GB at $1,249, 1TB at $1,499, and 2TB at $1,849. Now, obviously, all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colours. So we've seen some great colours in the concepts and renders that you're looking at right here. But also, there are some rumours and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is going to have all these multiple different colours that are going to be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space grey MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.